So Arnold, what was it like to be on stage?
Man, cool,
you called them both out.
Oh, yeah, it's cool, you know, because if one of them falls out, then that's what I'm
so you're ready. But who would you want to fight in the meantime? Who are you fighting? Do you know yet?
We don't know yet. We're going to hope to lock it in.
Jose Ramirez?
I tried, you know, but you know his manager don't want to.
Okay.
Probably want to do it.
And what do you think about this fight? Give me your prediction.
Man, you know what? I got Haney in the fight. I see him locked in right now. You know, I see him locked in. I see him anxious. I think he really wants to go in there and rip someone's head off. You know what I mean?
But you want the winner, correct?
Huh?
You want the winner?
I want the winner, of course. I want the winner of that, or you know, everyone else, they'll feel more, of course. But the winner of this, I'll take it.
All right, let's go. 29 and Arnold. Where do fans follow you?
Man, I'm on Instagram at Arnold_Barbosa_Junior, and on Twitter at JuniorBarbosaArnold.
All right, stay tuned.
Hey Arnold, I tell Ryan, I tell Devin, you gotta prove it in the ring. Talking all this shit outside the ring, move it in the ring.
This is a promoter's dream, right? Working this kind of an event?
Yeah, I mean, look, we're used to working with big fighters and big events, and, you know, this is obviously right up there, you know, my top 10. So I'm really looking forward to sitting down April 20th. At the Barclays, watching ringside and watching a great fight.
Oscar, you've been on fire so far. You started with Virgil's fight, then you have this fight, and before that, Zurdo, Martyr, and you have Zapata. Tell me about all the big schedule Golden Boy's putting out right now.
Yeah, we're bringing Virgil back, and we're back. I'm on a serious mission. And look, I've been in this business for 22 years now. When I'm serious, things happen. So I'm glad I'm back. Let's put it that way. I think that the whole boxing world and, you know, everyone that loves the game is gonna love the fact that we're gonna put the best against the best. That's all I want to do. I mean, I want to see Virgil Ortiz fight Terrence Crawford.
I love it.
I want to see Tim Zhu come back over here and unify with, you know, whoever. I want to see the best versus the best.
What about Munguia, Oscar? Munguia. What does he do next?
Munguia, he's waiting for his opportunity, man. He's waiting for his opportunity. Look, we're dealing with people, and his next fight will be announced soon. But I truly feel the way I preached, I don't know, a couple years ago, Canelo Munguia, an all-Mexican showdown. Hopefully we'll see it soon.
What's stopping that fight from happening next?
Look, Canelo holds all the cards. All I have to say is Canelo holds all the cards, and like you guys, I want to see Benavides Canelo. Yeah, it's great, but I also want to see Canelo Munguia, because it'll be a hell of a fight. It's a great action-packed fight. So any of those, we'll all be happy.
Oscar, what did Ryan and Haney talk about in the face-off? You were there in the mix right now.
A bunch of nonsense.
Yeah, they're all just trying to get into each other's head. You know,
does it work?
Just talking shit, this, that. Does it work? At that moment, it does, because you get heated up. But then you go back to your camp. You know, you work on what you work on. You know, you spar, you train, and you get ready physically, mentally. So all this trash talk really doesn't matter. Yep. It's how you focus once you step inside that ring.
By the way, it was beautiful to see you and Ryan at dinner. Tell me about that. Moving forward, you guys have a great relationship again, which is good to see.
Well, yeah, it's a start, right? So, one thing about me is that all I want to do is make the best fights. That's it. That's the bottom line. That's why you're seeing me with Bob Arum, with Eddie Hearn. You're seeing me with Samson Lykovic. You're seeing me with everybody, except Al Haymon. He's nowhere to be found. But I would love to talk to him as well. So what I want to do is make sure that we all come together, because it starts with the promoters. We have the fighters. Let's fight each other. Let's you know, let's make a round robin and figure out how we continue to grow the sport.
It appears Canelo's a free agent again. What is your message to him as far as working together once more?
First of all, I have no apology, because I have no idea what I did to him to end the relationship. But as a man myself, I would say, hey, I'm in your corner 1,000%. I love what you're doing, fighting the very best. That's my mantra there. Fighting the very best, and you know, go after the best tough fighters. You've been doing it for a long time. You know, whoever you choose, Cinco de Mayo, I mean, all the power to you. But if we ever have to work together, I'm respectful. I respect your career. All I want to do is make the best fights happen for the people, for the crowd, for the fans. That's what it's all about. Making those fights for the fans.
Did the New York media take you by surprise and the attention that the feedback that you got, given that Ryan hadn't had a major fight in New York?
What Ryan doesn't know is that his numbers are bigger in New York than they are in LA. And the reason why this fight is in New York is because you become a coast-to-coast champion. You become a world global star. So there's behind the thought, there's a madness, you know, that I think of, and you know, I take a look at the history of the sport and who fought in New York, who made it, who's the biggest, you know. So imagine the winner fighting this fight and winning becomes a global star. That's the bottom line. So that's the thought behind it.
Thank you guys.
Ellie Sekback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.